Hello everyone, we are here today with a new lesson. So I think this part will be really helpful for you even if it is a very small one. So today we are going to identify what are neutral atoms and what are ions. Okay, let's start. Now look at this. I have selected one sodium atom and one fluorine atom to describe neutral atoms. Okay, so first, now you already know that there are three main subatomic particles in any atom. They are protons, electrons and neutrons. Protons are positively charged particles, electrons are negatively charged particles, whereas neutrons, they have no charge. So here, I don't consider about neutrons. Okay, let's first take this sodium atom. So if you look at this one here, in the nucleus, there are positive charged protons. Here if you count that value, that will be 11. Okay, so positive 11. Then if you calculate the number of electrons, that will be 11 also. That means as this is an electrically neutral atom, there are protons with an equal number of with the electrons. Okay, then if you take this fluorine atom, if you count the number of protons inside the nucleus, that will be 9, and number of electrons will also be 9. Okay, so if you calculate the final charge of each atom, let's take this one first, positive 11 plus negative 11, that will be equal to 0. That means this atom finally has no charge. Then if you go to fluorine, that will also be like that, positive 9, negative 9. When you add these two, the value will be 0. That means no final charge in both the atoms. So if the final charge is 0 or no final charge in any atom, we call those atoms as neutral atoms. Okay, now we have to identify what are ions. Okay, let's go to that. Okay, now you can see here the sodium atom which I took earlier. As earlier, 11 positive charges and 11 negative charges are there. So, due to some reason, I'll explain you what is the reason in the next lesson. Okay, due to some reason, let's imagine that the sodium atom removes one electron from it. Okay. So what will happen? One electron is being removed from the sodium atom. Okay. Then what will happen? Let's count. Now number of protons, that does not change here. Okay. That will be positive 11 as earlier. But what will happen to the number of electrons? Now it has already removed one. Then negative charges will be changed as negative 10. So when you calculate the final charge, you have to add positive 11 plus negative 10. So what will happen? The final value will be positive 1. Okay, now see. Sodium atom now has been converted to a positive ion. Now we call that as not an atom, but as a cation or a positive ion. Okay, so neutral atoms, when remove electrons from them, they form cations. Okay. Now, here look at this one. This is the fluorine atom which I described you earlier. So here, if you calculate the number of protons, that is positive 9 as earlier. And if you calculate the number of electrons here, that is negative 9. So final charge is 0 as I described earlier. So that is a neutral atom at the beginning. Okay, so now due to some reason, this fluorine atom gains an electron. Okay, let's imagine that this fluorine atom gains an electron. Okay, then now here, what will happen if this fluorine atom gains one electron? Number of protons, that will not change, that will remain as positive 9. But number of electrons, what will happen? Now it has already gained one electron. So it is becoming negative 10. Okay.
Now, when you are calculating the final charge, that will be positive 9 plus negative 10. So, what will happen? The final charge will be negative 1. Okay. Now, you can see when the fluorine atom has gained one electron from the outside, it has converted to a negative ion or an anion. Okay. So, when any neutral atom gains electrons, it is being converted to an anion. Okay.
So, I think you've got a clear idea of what are electrically neutral atoms, cations and anions. So, this will really be helpful for you in all your next lessons. So, be with us. Don't forget to watch the next lessons.